Today we shall discuss epidemiology. The word epidemiology is derived from the Greek word epi, meaning upon, demos, which means people, and logos, meaning science. So it is the science of occurrence and the distribution of disease in the population. Disease may be nutritional, metabolic, malignant, and communicable ones. So, epidemiology of communicable disease means occurrence and the distribution of communicable disease. Occurrence and distribution will be studied in relation to two parameters: descriptive model and epidemiologic model. Descriptive model will be studied in relation to some questions asking about who, where, and when. The occurrence or determinant will be studied in relation to epidemiologic models or epidemiologic triangle dealing with agent, host, and environment. There is a difference between epidemiology and ecology. First, epidemiology is the science concerned with distribution and the occurrence of disease in the people, while ecology is the study of the natural history of the disease and the interaction of man with his environment. First of all, we have to know chain of infection or infectious cycle, which is a model used to understand the infection process. It consists of circle of Lennox. Each Lennox must be present and in sequential order for an infection to occur. Lennox are infectious agent, reservoir, portal of exit from the reservoir, mode of transmission, and the portal of entry into a susceptible host. Understanding the characteristics of each Lennox provides the methods to prevent spread of infection. Infectious agent. Microbiological agent of disease may be virus, rickettsia, bacteria, fungi, and the parasites. Any of these has to be available in sufficient number, inoculum, virulence, and the infectivity. Virulence is the ability of the causative organism to cause a disease. Infectivity, ability of the causative organism to cause infection. Also, there are pathogenicity, antigenicity, and so on. This is regarding an infectious agent. Second, reservoir. A reservoir of infection is an organism or habitat in which an infectious agent normally lives, metabolizes, transforms, and multiplies, and include man, animal, arthropod, and the soil. In man, include cases or carriers. Cases including either severe cases, intermediate cases, vague or mild cases, and so on. A carrier is a person harboring and discharging causative pathogenic agent without showing signs or symptoms of clinical manifestation. Animals, regarding a reservoir, the second reservoir animal, بجد ان المان is resistant to infection with most animal diseases with the exception of some like yellow fever, plague and brucellosis. These diseases are called zoonoses. Thirdly, the third reservoir is arthropod, like lice, fleas, ticks, mites, and mosquitoes. Well, man, or arthropod-borne diseases are classified according to type of vector into lice, which produce epidemic typhus, louse borne relapsing fever, and trench fever. Fleas, which produce plague and endemic typhus. Ticks that produce tick-borne relapsing fever, Rocky Mountain spotted fever, and Q fever. Mites, which produce rickettsial box diseases. And the mosquitoes that produce yellow fever, dengue fever, encephalitis, filariasis, and malaria. The last reservoir of infection is the soil. As for the spores of Clostridia tetani, Wilshire, and botulism, as well as some fungi infective to man. Human carrier. By human carrier is mean a person harboring and discharging pathogenic causative agent without showing signs and symptoms of disease. Significance of carriers. Carriers are more dangerous as reservoir of infection than sick persons because people are not aware of their condition and don't take protective measures against them. Secondly, their number is much greater than clinical cases. Thirdly, the carrier state may last for a prolonged period of time, especially in convalescent carriers. Types of carrier. Carriers are classified into three classifications. The first classification includes basic types, which include incubatory carrier, convalescent carrier, and the contact one. Incubatory carrier, by which is mean an infected person discharging the causative agent in his discharge while still in the incubation period and before start of symptoms of disease, as in measles and chickenpox during the last days of incubation. Second type includes convalescent carrier, by which is mean the patient may continue to discharge the causative organism for some time after recovery, as in cholera and diphtheria. The third type is the contact carrier, by which is mean an immune person in close contact with a patient suffering from a contagious disease that may carry the causative agent and transmit infection to others without himself showing manifestations of disease, as a mother nursing a diphtheritic child. The second classification includes chronic carrier, intermittent carrier, and the temporary one. By chronic carrier is mean a person carrying and discharging the causative agents for long periods, as in streptococcal throat carrier, that will lead to acute follicular tonsillitis, glomerulonephritis, and so on. Secondly, intermittent carrier. That means a person carrying and discharging the causative pathogenic air organism, but his excretion to this organism is intermittently, as in typhoid. The third type is acute or temporary carrier, by which is mean a person carrying and discharging the causative organism for a short period of time only, as in contact carrier and subclinical cases. The third classification include carriers according to site of carrier organism. That includes throat and or nasopharyngeal carrier, as in streptococcal carrier, intestinal carrier, as in cholera, typhoid, and poliomyelitis, eye carrier, as in conjunctival infectious agents, air carrier, as in fungal infections, and urinary ones, as in typhoid and brucellosis. Portal of exit. An infective organism leaves the reservoir through portals of exit, which are mostly the natural openings of the body. They include upper respiratory passage by droplets during the coughing, sneezing, and loud talking, as in influenza, tuberculosis, and meningococcal meningitis. Secondly, gastrointestinal tract in the stool, as in dysentery and typhoid, and in the vomitus, as in cholera. Thirdly, urine, as in salmonellosis and brucellosis. Fourthly, in blood, as in serum hepatitis by searing, and malaria by a sucking mosquito. Milk, as in bovine tuberculosis, brucellosis, and staphylococcal mastitis. Lastly, saliva, as in mumps in human and rabies in animal. Modes of transmission. These are the mechanisms by which an infectious agent is transmitted from reservoir to susceptible host. And they include inhalation of droplets carrying the causative organism, which might be directly, indirectly, and through airborne. First, directly from case to susceptible, as during coughing, sneezing, and loud talking. This is called person-to-person transmission. Secondly, indirectly, by inhalation of the causative organism in soiled articles or vomits of cases or carrier. And lastly, airborne, by dual mechanism of action. First is known as aerosols, and the second is dust laden with coarse particles. By aerosols, which are very light droplet nuclei in the air, carrying the causative organism and inhaled by a susceptible, as in Q fever. By dust laden with coarse particles, carrying the causative organism from sputum or other discharge as in dry sweeping of tuberculosis wart. The second mode of transmission include ingestion of contaminated food and drink. This is considered infection by a common vehicle and include hand soiled by excreta and used in eating or preparation of food. Secondly, flies carrying the infectious pro-organism from excreta to food and drink. Thirdly, contaminated water used in adulteration of milk or added to food eaten raw. فعلنا نتذكر حديث تتذكر ما دار بين المرأة الأعرابية وابنتها عندما قالت لابنتها قومي يا بني فأخلطي اللبن بالماء فقالت ألم ينهك أمير المؤمنين عمر بن الخطاب عن ذلك فأجابت الأم وأين عمر بن الخطاب الآن فكانت إجابة البنت إذا كان عمر لا يرانا فإن رب عمر يرانا فأعجب بها الخليفة وزوجها أحد أبنائه وكان من ذريته الخليفة العادل عمر بن عبد العزيز. The last is the use of excreta as manure to green vegetables eaten raw. The third mode of transmission of infectious agent, contact infections of skin and the mucous membrane, which occur through intact skin or abraded one. In intact skin, this infection occurs in fungal ones, including scabies. In addition, even to infectious stages of ankylostoma and schistosomiasis. In abraded skin, the infection occurs in tularemia and tetanus. The fourth mode of transmission is through blood and serum. This is considered the infection by a common vehicle, as in congenital syphilis, in HIV/AIDS, and in serum hepatitis. The last two, I mean, HIV/AIDS and serum hepatitis, are known as century plague. ولعلنا نتذكر حديث رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لم تظهر الفاحشة في قوم قط حتى يعلنوا بها إلا فشي فيهم الطاعون والأوجاع التي لم تكن ظهرت في أسلافهم الذين مضوا. صدقت يا رسول الله. The last mode of transmission of infection is by an arthropod-borne diseases may be classified according to type of vectors mentioned before. I mean through lice, fleas, ticks, mites, sandfly and malaria. Pattern of spread of communicable disease. The most common term used in describing epidemiology. A lot of terms face us and include epidemic, when a disease prevails with unusual excess than normal expectancy, attacking large number of people at the same time, and is derived from a common or propagated source in the community. They are known as epidemics, as cholera epidemic, Rift Valley fever epidemic, and SARS epidemic. Also, epidemic may issue on top of an endemic waves in a locality, or a disease which occurs previously not previously reported in a country or a locality. Secondly, is outbreak. Outbreak is a special entity of epidemic. It means epidemic within a closed or confined community, including camps, school, institutes, and so on. It must characteristically encountered in environments even in which sanitation is the most prevailing factor, as in gastroenteritis and food-borne diseases. Thirdly, endemic, by which is mean a disease which is always prevailing in a country or a locality, as in Schistosoma hematobium in Egypt, due to prevailing snails, malaria in Saudi Arabia, due to the widely encountered mosquito in Gazan region, filaria spread that occur in Mahallat Marhum region in Garbia Governorate, leprosy, which is found in Zifta region in Garbia Governorate. The fourth definition of pattern of spread is exotic, which means a disease imported into a country or a locality in which it did not otherwise occur. The fourth definition is pandemic, which is an entity of epidemic, meaning an epidemic spreading over some countries of the world within short period of time, as in quarantinable diseases including cholera, plague, smallpox, yellow fever, typhus, due to drastic severity or severity of disease, in addition to the wide prevalence rate, as in influenza. The sixth definition is sporadic, by which is mean scattered cases of disease which occur infrequently and showing little or no connection to each other, as in viral A hepatitis. The last pattern of spread of communicable disease is epizootic. It is in animal. It is the synonym of epidemic in human.